basketball. Here we are at Concordia University going to give you a tutorial or a move, a tutorial on a transitional move to hopefully help you create more space and put the defender in a situation where they have to give you a read. And off that read, you can make a quick decision and hopefully score. So when I was coming up, the move that you wanted to have, the move that I saw so many elite players do was the stutter step, right? They would pound the basketball, give you a quick change of speed, quick feet action, and that would do a couple things. Number one, it would help you change speed. You know, before you can develop your crossover, you just want to have a change of speed. A change of speed will do you wonders in terms of creating new opportunities to get separation. The other thing that it did was it allowed you an opportunity to read your defender. So when I pound the basketball and give my defender those quick feet and that hard pound with the basketball being in my hand, I had an opportunity to read if the defender was going to stay on my right side. If they stayed on my right side, then I could change direction. Or if I pounded the basketball and I saw that the defender didn't move, then I'd just keep going. So now what they do now is they had this thing, especially you see Russell Westbrook does it. He does what's called a hang dribble, where he pounds the basketball, and now he's giving you that same foot action, right? His hand is on top of the basketball, so it's not a carry. And then off of that same hang dribble, he can either go into a jump shot or he can go into a drive. So he can go here, do that again. He can pound it and go into a shot, or he can pound it and then accelerate. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some of those different things and combine them with this thing that we see a lot of elite guards doing, where they'll pound the ball, give you the foot action without touching it. And what they're doing is they want to bait you. So what happens is they pound the ball, give you the foot action, and they want you to reach in. Okay, we want the defender to reach in. So now let me go back. A lot of the drills that I do, I try to make sure that they are not super elite, but not super basic, somewhere in the middle, all right? I never want an elite player to come to my channel and say, this stuff is too basic, it's too rudimentary, I can't use any of this stuff. At the same time, I don't want a beginner to go to my channel and say, man, this stuff is too complex. So I try to find stuff in the middle. But I will admit, this move errs on the side of being more elite than basic, because again, we're putting the ball out there, hoping that the defender will make a read or reach so that we can go ahead and teach and go the other way. So let's work on it. Now, this is a move that you can do in the half court, all right, if you're really, really elite. But I think even if you are an intermediate player, you're learning your game, you're developing, I think you can still use this move, especially in a transition situation. But if you're really elite and you got a really strong handle, then you can use this move in half court situations. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a move to get myself on the go. Actually, I'll come the other way. So I get my move, do a move to get myself on the go. What I'm going to do is I'm going to throw that basketball out in front. Not completely out in front where it can get snatched away, but I'm just going to throw the ball right here, and I'm going to give you my foot action. When I give you that foot action, I'm going to give you a little bit of stutter step action, and then I'm going to go. Now, I'm going to do a couple different versions of it. There's going to be a couple times where I'm just going to pound it, reach forward, snatch it, and go to the basket, and then I'm going to do a couple others where I'm going to reach it here and then pound it and then take off, right? So let's see what it looks like. But notice how I combine that stutter step, not necessarily hand dribble, but definitely taking this dribble here, pounding it, letting it come up so that I can either shoot it if I wanted to or accelerate, but I'm just going to go strictly to the basket. There we go. Some more foot action. So you saw two versions of it. One was straight to the cup, one was with the dribble. I'll give you two more so you can hopefully see it. I'm gonna try to get a little bit more detail, get a little lower, give you better foot action so hopefully you can see this stuff. Now here's my grab and go. Now you see, when you're coming down full speed, you're throwing the ball over here. This is simply just a bait move. It's just a setup move. Now, I also can shoot off of this too. Now again, if you have the ability to shoot in transition, this used to be a good shot back in the day to come full speed on transition. If they took away your wings, hit the 15-footer. That was a prerequisite every guard had to have. Now they'd rather take away this shot and kick it out to the corner. But if you can still shoot this shot, here's a good setup, because if you're right-handed and you throw it here, now you basically get to walk into that shot. Let's look at that. That's another way we can get to that shot. So let's talk about now the counter, right? So after I make that move, when I go here, that's the footwork I'm giving you. I'm giving you basically hard left to right. So once I go here, hard left to right, hoping that the defender's gonna take something away. If the defender takes something away, there's my counter move. So now I'm going from this pound dribble, and then once I see that defender comes, I'm then taking that ball out of the air and going immediately into a change of direction. I'll do a cross, but I'll also do a between the legs move. Let's watch. Between the legs. Let's go between the legs again. Better foot action next time. Then last one. I did that one already. Crossover. That's that high left, high release. So now, last one. This is the inverted jab. Inverted jab means when I make my move, here's the outside. Here's the inside. I want to do an inverted jab. See if I can. Now, it may look like a travel. It may feel like a travel when you see it happen in the game and when you do it at first. Because basically, we're using three steps when normally all you get is gather, one, two. But we're using three steps to create our score. But remember that jab step, that inverted jab step, you don't have the ball in your hand. So that's where that one, two, three comes from. So when I go here, one, I don't have the ball. I just did my inverted step. My gather, I want to gather with my right, left. Let's look at it. So what you saw in that last, hopefully, what you saw in the slow motion action is, when I go here, now, as the ball's in the air, I'm giving you, again, fast footwork, but I want to make sure that when I give you that footwork, I'm giving you right, hard, left. So as the ball is in the air, and you've given that guy the or that defender, or you giving them this move early in the game, when you pound the ball here, but they see your entire body shift, they shift. Because in the situation, when you're going full speed, you don't have a lot of time to think and react, okay? Unless you really, really know that you have a mental advantage over the person because you know their tendencies. But when you see a person's entire body sidestep, the action's happening so fast that you gotta make a read, you gotta respond. So once that body goes over here, that gives you the ability now to take the basketball and keep going. The last one I will show you is what happens when you can do, is what happens if you do a little bit deeper, if you can just move a little deeper, and now you can Euro step out of it. This will be the last one. So now I make my move here, I dribble, I may throw it over here hard. Now I may throw it over here hard. Again, this person is backing up, so I know I have an advantage because they're backing up. Once I throw it over here hard, I then go over here and get it. Now, mind you, this move only works because prior to this move that I'm gonna do now, I've shown the basketball right side, and I've continued to go to the right side. So once that defender sees the ball going right, he sees body going right, he sees the footwork going right, that's when you step hard, go left, and then you gotta score. Let's look at it, see if I can get a couple to go down. I'll do four of them. Go the other way. Also, when you Come back. Don't go over there just yet. Follow me. Also, when I'm doing this move, I don't have my normal vert because I'm jumping sideways, so I don't have the, I'm not jumping vertical, so I don't have a lot of weight, a lot of vert. So what I gotta do now is, I gotta have a higher finish to compensate for the fact I'm not jumping like I normally jump. If I was jumping here, I can get high, I can jump over the top if I'm that type of athlete. But now I'm going here, here. My energy is spaced out or spread out. Now I can't jump as high, and that's when I have to now finish with a high release. Now if you're Giannis Antetokounmpo, it doesn't matter. You can finish that. But if you're not him, if you're me, or like me, you're gonna be craftier with the ball. Two more. Last one. There you have it, downhill transition move, where we utilize a couple different things. The old school stutter step, and then we also move the concept of the hang dribble. Well, not necessarily hang dribble, but basically that hard pound that comes with the hang dribble, where you pound it and you make your move. And what happens is we want to pound it, make our hands free, so that we can either grab it for a score, grab it for a shot, or put the ball back on the ground to dribble past the defender. But we're using all these different moves to hopefully get the defender backing up, get them to reach, or get them to make a read one way or the other, so that hopefully we can take advantage of it and go for our bucket. How would I do this drill if I was in the gym by myself working out? I would just work on one concept for 5 minutes. Right, left, right, left, right, left, in the middle. Free throw, free throw. Right, left, right, left, right, left. Start with the basics. Evolve into the point where now you're doing moves. And you might even get to the point where you start your dribble earlier. And now you add combination moves and different finishes to make it complex. So maybe next week I'll start adding some different moves to a build up so you can see some of the possibilities you can use when doing that move. Meticulous basketball, again, my son was doing the filming. And so hopefully he was able to stay focused and capture me this whole time through. Mark Fight Stream, Meticulous Basketball, more drills to come. Done.